A t-test is usually used to determine if there is a significant difference between subgroups on a particular score. For instance, we might be interested to know whether females indicated that their satisfaction with the teaching on a course was significantly different from the way the males responded. To undertake a t-test, you need a category variable to group your participants and then a continuous variable. In the Data View tab, select the Analyze menu. Select Compare Means. Select Independent Samples t-test. First, select the variable you wish to examine. This is your continuous variable. Then select the category variable and put it in the grouping variable box. Now click on Define Groups. In this stage, we indicate which subgroups are being compared. If we're comparing males to females, and we had indicated that males were labelled 1 and females labelled 2, we would put 1 and 2 into these boxes. Select OK. Select Continue. Select OK. The output provides two tables. The first table provides the means for each group. The second table provides the actual t-test. We interpret this in two stages. First, we look at the Levine test. This looks at the variances or dispersion of each of the groups. If the significance value is larger than 0.05, we can assume that the variances are equal, and we use the first row of scores in the t-test section. If the significance value for the Levine test is less than 0.05, we assume the variances for the two groups are not equal, and we use the bottom row of the t-test section. In this case, we can see the variances are not equal, so we use the second row. The t-value is here, and the probability or significance value is here. If this value is less than 0.05, we can assume that the groups are different. In this example, we can conclude that males and females reported significantly different levels of satisfaction with teaching. If we look at the first table, we can see that the males' mean score was lower than the females. For a t-test, we report the t-value and significance value.